Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. It's a Pop Tart Lee with my haul and overview, review, whatever you want to call it, of Star Wars Celebration. The long and short of it is I had an amazing time, really enjoyed myself. Went on the Saturday just for the day. A day was long enough for me on the basis of I didn't have any autographs planned in or anything like that, so I was able to get around, do everything I wanted to do. Yeah, it was super busy. Big queues, but I expected that. I would rather have this kind of thing where it was like that and it was available to the masses rather than be less people and basically people miss out. So everyone was there for the same reason. There was a really good atmosphere about it. I mean, straight away in the queue, there was a big massive Chewbacca. That bloke, he must have been absolutely exhausted just by the end of the queue, because he was on his stilts for the whole time. And he'd probably be a sweaty mess by the end of the con. But we literally walked in, and the first kind of room we went in to look into, you'd have seen, if you haven't already, the pictures and video I did. That was a separate video, which I'll link in the description. But walked into a room, and there in front of us, no more than 10 yards away, Jon Favreau, Kathleen Kennedy. Just amazing. Like, Jon Favreau is just somebody who I have always appreciated, just as an actor, before he even got involved in The Mandalorian. Back to my early days of going to the cinema with my brother, late night films, we saw, not that kind of film, Wayne Deacon, we saw a film called Swingers, just on the off chance, and I've loved that guy ever since. So it was great to just see him in the flesh. Tried, obviously, in vain to get a decent selfie. It didn't happen. But yeah, that was really, really cool. And then it was off just, first of all, we just kind of had a walk around the stalls. Little bit disappointed with the figure stall. There's really good display. I think it was called Hasbro Pulse, but not able to buy anything. I found that a little bit odd, because there was some really cool stuff there that maybe as an impulse I would have probably gone for. But everything else was pretty well set out. The art gallery was kind of the main bit in the room we were in, first of all, and some of the stuff was fantastic. Didn't buy anything. I reckon if I'd been there with my missus, you know, we probably would have ended up buying something. But I couldn't spend that kind of money with the thought of it then having to be in the loft. It would have to be something from the main house. But picked up every single one of the artists was there, and they all had these kind of cards with them. So apparently each artist did two cards each, exclusive for the con, that you could pick up, and they were more than happy to let you take these. I think it was called Kanji Collab. But some of them had, I mean, that one on the back, it's got a little bit about the artist, and you could go and follow them on Instagram and everything like that. Picked up pretty much all of these, I believe, as we were going around. Some of the artists were really nice as well. They were happy that they knew you were just coming to pick up these kind of things. But they were happy just that people were looking at their art, and they were happy to talk about it as well. This is probably, as I'm going to go through them, I'm just going to show you them all bit by bit, but that's probably my favourite out of them. That's got like a nice glossy finish. That one's by someone called Jason Davies. But yeah, really like that one. Keep going. I'll just try and keep talking as I'm going through these. So yeah, I did all the stalls more than once, to be fair, and I only actually did one purchase off the stalls in total, which I'll show you in a minute. I found, obviously, Funko. There was some sellers there, but as with most cons, I didn't see anything that I didn't feel I could pick up cheaper, either online or, obviously, I've been collecting a while, I didn't already have. That's another cool one, actually, the Vader one. We're getting there now with these, sorry. And that was the last one of those. That was like a robot is lost image on the back. I'm now looking at this one, and I think this one maybe is just something completely different that I've kind of put in with there. But yeah, my one pickup that wasn't from the Celebration store, wasn't from the Funko store, was this cool t-shirt, Chewbacca t-shirt. In the end, these were, I believe t-shirts were £20 each or three for 50. So myself, Lee and Rich all kind of went in, split it three ways. All got a t-shirt each. Lee actually got the same one as me, so you'll probably see that in a future video. Funko store wise, I did go in. It wasn't that big, to be honest with you. It was a nice experience, because you kind of, as you were going in, you were made to feel, the staff were really good. They made you feel special. You got your picture taken if you wanted it, as mine. Slightly awkward with the new Rivals game with Boba Fett and Ahsoka Tano, but I thought that was just a nice little touch. And I had a little wander around, had a look. Alex, there's two purchases, but I'm just going to show you one for now, which is the obvious. I did pick up Jar Jar Binks. I'm an out-of-box collector. If you're new to this channel, found it through this, you can see some of my Star Wars pops here. But I did get suckered in by the fact it'd be nice to have a Star Wars Celebration sticker. I don't know if the back of the box is similar to the one you get from Funko Europe, but I got suckered in by this one, £19. I can't believe I'm saying this. This is going to be an inbox pop for me. I'm going to get it in a protector. So I'm not even going to get him out like I normally wouldn't have him on the spin, or this video will go too long as it is if I do that. But yeah, so I got Jar Jar Binks, £19. Happy with that one. Celebration Store, I didn't enjoy it as much. It felt a little bit upmarket. A lot of the stuff, I couldn't see prices, but there was a few things that I wanted to pick up, and I did. So the first one is my Num Num, is my co-pilot t-shirt. Massive fan of Num Num, always have been. So he's a character where if I see something of him, chances are I'm gonna pick it up. And I didn't realize until, obviously they passed it me by hand because it was all behind. Basically someone, you point to a t-shirt, they tell you, but it did have Star Wars Celebration on as well. So that's nice that it's got that kind of little bit of authenticity and a memory. I picked up a Max Rebo plush. This was very, very impulse. Again, I like the Cantina, I like Jabba's Palace, I like the kind of bits and bobs from that, and I just thought Max Rebo looked really cool. So he will find a home in here. Again, it's another bit of official Star Wars Celebration merch. He was £18. Again, a little bit impulsive, but I don't know, I feel ridiculous saying it. It's only money, I'm only gonna do it once. And then I did the two magnets, which was the Return of the Jedi 40th, which I'll get onto a little bit more in a minute. And also this Star Wars Celebration, that was kind of like the main icon for the event. So I picked up those two. These ones were from Beyond the Till. Turned out they were £10 each, which again, for a magnet, just bamboozles me, but I've done it now. And I'm happy that I have them because they are gonna look really cool. And they are, ridiculous saying it. They're really good quality, but they're magnets. Couldn't get the Star Wars Celebration pin I was after, which was a shame. And the pins in general, like I said, everything was kind of behind the counter. It was just, I didn't enjoy the experience in the store. I didn't get to go in with anyone else. Whether that made a difference, I felt like it'd have been nice to if everyone could have got in. I understand how they did what they did, but I was lucky enough. I did the Funko shop and I did the Celebration store by getting the pre-reservations. So it was good. Not everything was pre-reservation. One thing we decided we were definitely all going to try and do was a panel, and we went to the Return of the Jedi panel, which was it was excellent. Again, queuing for quite a while. But once we got in there, there was like a warm-up act guy. He was really good. Got some fans on stage, they did a bit. And then, first of all, it was Ming-Na Wen who came out, which was a nice touch. You could tell she was super excited. She comes across really, really nice in public. If you haven't already, check out Leroy Scrooble's video where he got her autograph. She just seems like a really nice lady, to be fair. Brought out some of the kind of behind-the-scenes people from Return of the Jedi. And then we got some of the stars, Anthony Daniels, Warwick Davis, Emperor Palpatine, I can't remember his name, Ian McDiarmid, and Billy Dee Williams. I will say I felt a bit sorry for Billy Dee Williams. Obviously he's in his 80s now, but he didn't seem like he wanted to be there or just felt uncomfortable being there. Wasn't really responsive to the questions, which made it quite difficult for the compere. And then at the end he read out a little bit about his new book, and at the end he just started to walk off the stage. So I felt sorry for him. I think it's really good that he still made the effort to be there at that age. But I don't know if he'll be attending too many more events like that. I mean, who am I to know? But yeah, it was a shame. But at the end of that, before we went in, we were given a raffle ticket, which picked up these with amazing Return of the Jedi posters by Matt Ferguson. So really, really pleased to get hold of one of these. I've actually got an Empire Strikes Back one, which was picked up by my friend Darren, who I went to the con with a while ago. So all I need now is if he's done a New Hope poster, that'd be awesome. But this one's gonna get framed. The frame is due to come any minute now. And when we picked that up, I picked mine up separately with my mate Mike. I went back with Lee and Rich when they picked theirs up, and I knew that the day before they'd been giving out Mandalorian posters, so I decided I'd try my best. There wasn't many people there. Sweet talk the member of staff, and you know what, he was sound. He gave me and Lee one of the Mandalorian posters as well, which is really cool. I need to get this one framed as well. Really weird size, I think it's 13 by 19, but yeah. The eventual aim will be to get rid of these ones that are behind me now, just have a wall of some of the artwork I've picked up recently. It's been amazing. I'm now looking around me because I'm trying to think, what have I not shown you, what have I not talked about? Autographs, I didn't get any. I did think it was, I've been vocal about this, I thought they were quite expensive for what they were, but you know what, the ones I've seen where people have been, I've seen Warwick Davis obviously talking with Lee and Rich, the interactions, everyone seemed to be putting that little bit of extra time in compared to other cons I've been to. But I did get one really good experience during that area. There was a load of signings going on one side. My friend Mike is a big Andy Serkis fan. He wanted to go over and see Andy Serkis. As he was walking down there, I just stopped to have a quick drink. And I just turned the other way just to see who was due to be on the other side. And literally 5 yards away from me was Carl Weathers. As much as he's Greef Karga, he is Apollo Creed for me. He is obviously from Predator. So I thought, I just went, all right, stuck my thumb up, and he just waved back and said hello, and then he just disappeared again. And it's like, that was my little experience with cold weathers, which will stay with me as long as I can remember. So that was really, really cool for me. You weren't supposed to film in the area at all. I did try a cheeky bit of footage. I'll put it overlay somewhere. Mads Mikkelsen, again, another really cool actor. People who I'd like to meet at cons, but going back to, if we say Andy Serkis, I've spoke to other people about this after the con. I love Andy Serkis. I think he was amazing, Andor, absolutely amazing. But if I'm ever going to get his autograph, it's always going to be Gollum. So that'd be the one for me. Looking around me now, trying to think what else we're not showing you. Oh, Lego poster. They were giving these away as well. I didn't go into the Lego store. I picked this up. This is going to go to my friend's daughter. She doesn't know it yet, so hopefully she won't see this before she gets it. And there was also like a big full scale Emperor Palpatine. I took a photo. They then emailed it to you. And yeah, so I got one of those. Trying to think what else I got. Oh, there's one more thing. So the Funko store, obviously you had to queue to get in. We were lucky enough, the guy at the back door seemed in a decent mood. We were talking to him and he let us sneak in because there weren't many people in the shop. And on my second visit, I actually did pick up something else as well. I picked up another one of these awesome comic covers. I have one of these before, the Black Panther one, and I've been picking up these retro figures. So this one was £20 and I thought it was a no-brainer to pick that up. I had got a Luke on order, which I'm now going to pass over to somebody else, but I really like these. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with this one, whether I'm going to take the card off or not. I think the card on this is actually really cool. I'm sure you can get a protector of some sort for it, but I like the colours. I think they're vibrant, bright, and I do think it kind of sits well with the rest of it. I will take, because my, you can see the cellophane bit has got little tears in, so I need to unbox that and take that away and do something with that. But that was my last purchase of the day. Like I said, for £20, I took more money than I spent, which is always nice with cons. I could have been impulsive, I could have bought some other things, but I didn't. I've just seen the length of this video, so I apologise if it's gone on a bit. But the long and short of it is, I had a fantastic experience. Call me soppy, but a big part of that was the people I went with. There was a different groups of us from different places, but we all gelled really well, had a really cool day. And I can see us all going to cons again together in the future, which is really nice and something to look forward to. I think MCon will be my next one this year. But yeah, it was just good. This is how I always end up. I'm not sure how to finish this video, but just chat away. Let me know in the comments if you went, anything you want. As long as it's about celebration, I still have got that buzz. It's quite hard to come down from it, to be honest with you. I know that I've been to a number of cons over a number of years, but this one just felt special. I had a really cool time, and I'm going to stop talking about it, and that will do. So until the next one, guys, plenty more content coming up in the next few weeks. So if you're new to the channel, cool if you stick around, but by all means don't if you don't want to. And until then, look after yourself, take care, bye for now, bye.